random variable z equivalent to x plus y, where x and y are two independent random variables with probability densities fx of x equivalent to 1 by 2 u of x plus 1 minus u of x minus 1, and fy of y is equivalent to e power minus y u of y. We have to evaluate this fz of z. So we already know that this fz of z is equivalent to fx of x convolution with fy. Okay. So here we perform the graphical convolution because both the functions can be plotted. So better to follow the graphical convolution method to obtain the convolution between these two functions. First plot both the functions. This is x, x of x. So fx of x is equivalent to 1 by 2 from minus 1 to 1. Is it right? Because fx of x is given as 1 by 2 times u of x plus 1 minus u of x minus 1. So u of x plus 1 minus u of x minus 1 indicates a rectangular pulse. And it is, its magnitude is equivalent to 1 by 2. See here, the area under this probability density function is equivalent to 1. That condition is satisfied. What is the next one? It is e power minus y u of y. So that is fy of y e power minus y u of y. That indicates e power minus y for y greater than or equivalent to 0 and 0 for y less than 0. So therefore, this is exponentially decaying like this. And this is 0 for y less than 0 and this value is 1. So that is, this will become 0 at y equivalent to infinity. Understood? So what is the first step that we should do? Place x with tau, and this is, so we got fx of tau, some dummy variable. Okay. And we need to evaluate, see what is actually fz of z. Fz of z is equivalent to minus infinity to plus infinity. This is fx of some dummy variable into fy of z minus tau d tau. So we know fx of tau, this is fx of tau. Now we have to find fy of z minus tau. So here this is fy of y. How can you get fy of z minus tau? See, here in this equation, if you substitute y equivalent to z minus tau in this, here if you substitute y equivalent to z minus tau, can you get fy of z minus tau? You can get. So from this, this tau is equivalent to z minus 1. You plot it. Plot the fy of z minus tau. So this is tau, we have to plot fy of z minus tau. See, when y equivalent to 0, when y equivalent to 0 here, what is tau? Tau equivalent to z. That is, let this is z. And when y equivalent to 0, what is fy of y? This is 1. So the corresponding value is z. So therefore at z it is, what is this value? This is some 1, is it? this is minus 1, because now when y equivalent to 1, what is tau? Z minus 1. So if this is z, this will be z minus 1. See, for z minus 1, this is a value. Hello, that is from 0 to 1, if y is varying from 0 to 1, it is decaying like this. What are the corresponding values? Z and z minus 1. So therefore, between z and z minus 1, it should vary like this. For example, if you take 2, y equivalent to 2, what you will get? Z minus 2. This is z minus 2. Same value you are getting. Now, when y equivalent to minus 1, what is tau? This is z plus 1. So when y equivalent to minus 1, this is 0. So corresponding value z plus 1, for z plus 1 also it is. See, what we have done here, we reversed it and shifted it. So this is the fy of z minus 1. See, we already plotted this, now we plotted this. Understood? What is the next step? We have to take the product of this and this. Take the product of this and this for different values of z. And then find the integral of that particular, and find the area over that particular product curve. Then you will get fz of, consider z is less than minus 1. This is fx of tau, so which is lying between minus 1 and plus 1. Which is equivalent to 1 by 2. Okay. So that can be plotted like this. Z. So what is z here? Z is less than minus 1. What is this curve? This curve is the fy of z minus tau. Is it? This curve is fy of z minus. What is this value? This value is 1. So this is 1 by 2, this is 1. Understood? In the remaining interval it is 0. That is, this is 0. So product is 0. So therefore area under that is also 0. So when z less than minus 1, this fz of z is equal to another case, let z is lying in between minus 1 and 1. Z is lying between minus 1 and plus 1. So this value is equivalent to 1. So this curve is again fy of z minus 1. It is still fy of z minus 1. The only difference is the z value. Here z is less than minus 1. Here z is lying in between minus 1 and plus 1. Now if you observe over this interval, so over this interval, that is from minus 1 to z, this is non-zero. In the remaining interval, it is 0. Because this is 1 by 2, but this is 0. Similarly, here both are, this is something, but this is 0. Okay. Therefore, this is non-zero in the interval minus 1 to z. Then, this fz of z is equivalent to minus 1 to z. So what is fx of tau? Fx of tau is 1 by 2 and fy of z minus tau. What is fy of z minus tau? What is fy of z minus tau? See, what is fy of y? Fy of y is equivalent to e power minus y, u of y. And fy of z minus tau is equivalent to e power minus z minus tau, u of z minus tau. So therefore, this is e power minus z minus tau e of z minus tau d tau. Understood this? See, what is e of z minus tau? See, e of z minus tau is equivalent to 1 for z minus tau greater than 0. 0 for z minus tau less than 0. Okay. This is, this implies tau less than or equivalent to 0. This implies tau greater than, for tau less than z. See here, what is this? This is tau. For tau less than z, okay, that is this region. So minus 1 to z indicates tau less than z, is it? See, the interval that we considered is minus 1 to z. From minus 1 to z, tau is less than z. Okay, tau less than equal to, for tau less than z, this value is equivalent to 1. Therefore, what is this value? This is, find it. This is becoming 1. Why? Because for tau less than z, this value is equal to 1 from this, is it? So minus 1 to z indicates tau, see, tau value is less than z. Tau is taking values from minus 1 to z. See, the integration is with respect to tau. So these are the values of tau, is it? We consider tau is less than z, therefore this value is 1. How much you got? Okay, we are using the graphical convolution method, because the graphical convolution is the simplest one. So if you are able to plot the given functions, then the graphical convolution is the best solution to find the convolution between those two functions. Now what is the next case? Now let z greater than 1. Now let z is greater than or equivalent to 1. See, this is the first case, second case, and now we are letting the third case. Again, plot. This is tau, we are keeping effects of tau as it is. 0, and this is 1, this is minus 1, here we have 1 by 2. See, now z is greater than or equivalent to 1, that is, z is somewhere here, is it? This is z. Now this function is varying like this. So where it will become 0? This green line at minus infinity. Until minus infinity it is non-zero. So this is 1. So this curve is the e power, sorry, f y of z minus 1. Now, if you observe this, see, over this region, it is non-zero. The product is non-zero. In the remaining interval, the product is 0. So therefore, the area is also 0. Then, this fz of z is equivalent to integral minus 1 to 1, is it? Because from minus 1 to 1 it is non-zero, otherwise it is 0. It is 1 by 2 e power minus z minus tau u of z minus tau with 1. Find this value. Now plot fz of z. So if you summarize, this fz of z is equivalent to 0 for z less than minus 1, that equivalent to, then how it look like? This. Here it is very clear, this fz of z is greater than or equivalent to 0. The first property is satisfied. Now if you find the area under this, you can also show that integral minus infinity to plus infinity, this fz of z is equivalent to 1. Because these two conditions must be satisfied, then only it will be a valid probability density. So from the plot it is very clear that this is always greater than 0. Whatever may be the value of the z, this is always greater than or equivalent to 0 and its area must be equivalent to 1. You can verify it. You integrate this power minus infinity to plus infinity.